If it bleeds, it leads. But is that statement correct? Hi, my name is Matt Smilix, and today we are going to take a look at why certain people watch and enjoy horror movies.
In general, horror movies aren't very popular. When going to the movies, people are less likely to go watch a horror movie and they are rated lower than other film genres. Even in award shows, it becomes clear that horror movies only tend to win awards for technical achievements. The Omen in 1976 won Best Score, and Alien in 1979 won Best Visual Effects. Despite the lack of moviegoers and awards, the horror genre is still very well known. A lot of us like celebrating Halloween, and there are many horror-related conventions and festivals such as Weekend of Hell, Frightfest, and Screamfest. But why do some people absolutely love the genre, and why do others despise it? The answer may lie in our personality. When taking a look at personality and movie genres, we could say that people who are kind and extroverted watch more comedy movies, people who are assertive and emotionally stable like thriller movies, and people who are focused, organized, and chase success prefer documentaries. However, that information is just made up. Personality isn't that simple. People have different traits that can mean different things, and when talking about personality and interests, we can only talk about correlations and not causation. This is important to know for this video. Just because you have a certain personality trait doesn't mean that everything related to that trait automatically applies to you. So, if I say that extroverts like comedy movies, it may not apply to you because we're talking about a connection or relation between a trait and the interest, not a given result. Personality can be divided into 5 traits: neuroticism, extraversion, openness to experience, agreeableness, and conscientiousness. Neuroticism consists of 6 facets: anxiety, hostility, depression, self-consciousness, impulsiveness, and vulnerability. People who are neurotic are more nervous, worried, and anxious than people who score lower on neuroticism. The 6 facets of extroversion or warmth: gregariousness, assertiveness, activity, excitement-seeking, and positive emotions. Extroverts are more affectionate and they enjoy social activities. Openness consists of openness to fantasy, aesthetics, feelings, actions, ideas, and values. They are more willing to embrace new things and ideas, and they are open-minded and curious. People who score high on agreeableness are usually trusting, straightforward, and altruistic. They are less likely to be aggressive and are more likely to show empathy. The last trait is conscientiousness. People who are conscientious are careful, they want to achieve success and aim to complete tasks. They tend to be organized and show self-discipline. Horror is a big genre consisting of multiple subgenres. You have slasher films such as Friday the 13th and A Nightmare on Elm Street. Then you have gore movies or torture porn such as Saw and Hostel. There are also monster films like It or The Babadook and many more. We will mainly focus on violent media such as slashers and gore. First, I will discuss how watching and or enjoying horror relates to the big 5 personality traits I discussed earlier. Several of the neuroticism facets were positively related to watching violent media. People who display the facet of hostility tend to watch more cop shows, and people who tend to be more vulnerable were less likely to watch true crime. However, there were no significant relations between neuroticism and liking violent content. So, people who are neurotic tend to watch violent media but don't necessarily like it. They also tend to feel scared quicker while watching horror movies. For extroversion, there was a positive relation with movie watching in general, especially when the people tend to spend less time on social activities but seek sensation. However, they may also watch those movies in a social setting. Extroverts seem to not watch a lot of television like TV shows, but when they do, there is a significant association between extroversion and violent genres. Sensation seeking plays a bigger role. It is a search for thrill and adventure, seeking experience, disinhibition, and how susceptible we are to boredom. To some extent, these 4 facets of sensation seeking have been found to be able to predict how likely it is that a person will enjoy horror, especially disinhibition. People who seek sensation and excitement may have a higher interest in horror. Agreeableness is negatively associated with liking violent content, especially people who portray the facet of modesty because they may be repelled by the nature of the content. However, people who are trustful and straightforward did enjoy true crime. A group of people tend to feel scared more easily than others. And just like extroverts, they may watch horror movies together with others, which does decrease their fearful reaction. Empathy is an important factor of agreeableness. Empathy can be explained by three different constructs. Perspective taking, which is to what degree one can transpose themselves into the feelings or actions of fictional characters. Empathetic concern, which is to what degree one feels sympathy for others. And lastly, personal distress, which measures the amount of distress experienced in relationships. In general, it is reported that people who enjoy horror movies have less empathy. Low empathy and fearfulness are associated with more enjoyment and desire to watch horror films. People with higher levels of empathy do not enjoy to see people suffer in scary movies, but they do enjoy excitement and happy endings. These people may still enjoy a horror movie if it has a resolved ending, or if it's thrilling because they can empathize with the characters. These people, however, will probably not enjoy gore movies because of their destructive footage and storyline. Not much could be found on conscientiousness and openness. Only that conscientious people tend to be less afraid after watching horror movies. They are probably the people who can watch a horror movie and go straight to bed. For openness, a correlation was found in both watching horror movies and enjoying them. This effect was especially present in people who are open to aesthetics. Some other personality traits that can play a role are the dark personality traits such as Machiavellianism, narcissism, psychopathy, and sadism. Machiavellians enjoy power and manipulation. They may deceive and exploit others for their own benefit. There is a very strong correlation between Machiavellianism and the enjoyment of horror. Psychopathic traits are, for example, low empathy, lack of remorse, superficial charm, high intelligence, etc. People who portray these traits tend to prefer graphically violent movies. When the person also shows callous and emotional traits, they show less emotions while watching these movies. For example, they have reduced facial expressions for sadness or disgust. There are also some differences between men and women. In general, men enjoy scary and violent content more than women. They are also less scared, have a greater preference for horror, and watch it more frequently. When both men and women from the same age watched a fragment of Nightmare on Elm Street, men found it less boring, more frightening, and more satisfying. A little fun fact is that men expressed more distress when they watched the movie together with a woman who was also in distress, and women interacted more with men who were not afraid. Another difference was found between men and women in regards to how graphic the content should be. In general, men tend to prefer graphic horror material more than women. Men also watch more violent media on TV and are more likely to attend horror movies. One possible explanation for this is proposed by the gender socialization theory, which states that men are taught to not be afraid or at least not to show their fear. However, women are less constrained by such expectations. A second explanation is the disgust sensitivity of women. Disgust is a protective response to a threat, such as contamination and disease. Women react stronger to seeing insects, sores, feces, and women are less likely to work in environments in which pathogen exposure is likely. To end the video on a more lighthearted note, here is a summary on how to survive a horror movie. A content analysis of 10 slasher movies reported that 1/3 of sex scenes ended with the death of a character. An analysis of 56 slasher movies found that men and women were just as likely to be killed. However, women are more likely to survive, or at least one woman, the final girl. Movie makers devote more screen time to the deaths of women than men. Women that get killed off are more likely to be promiscuous, wear revealing clothing and appear nude, use sexual language and engage in intercourse when they are killed. However, men who don't survive are usually only identified by their use of sexual language. Thank you so much for watching. If you like these types of videos, please press that subscribe button. I wish you all a very nice day. Bye bye!